And time for today's broadcast of Choral Evensong, which comes live from Gloucester Cathedral. In this afternoon's service, there are two first broadcast performances. A new setting of the Canticles, written for the choir by John Saunders, a former organist of Gloucester Cathedral. And we'll also hear for the Anthem, a new setting for double choir of the ancient hymn Te Deum Laudamus by Mark Blatchly, a former assistant organist of the Cathedral. The service opens now with words from the Old Testament Song of Solomon, set to music by Walton. Set me as a seal upon thine heart.
Thank you. appointed for this evening are Psalms 28 and 29. The congregation are invited to sit during the singing.
Thank you.
This evening is a setting of the Te Deum Laudamus, the music by Mark Blatchly.
Thank you. Let us pray. On this, the eve of the 45th anniversary of the accession of our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, we pray for her and for her family, for her Prime Minister and government, for the Members of Parliament, and for one another, her beloved people. Gracious God, the only King of glory, you have given us your servant Elizabeth to be our Queen. Strengthen her with your grace, enrich her with the precious gifts of your Holy Spirit, and grant that we, her people, may dedicate ourselves after her example to your service, through Jesus Christ, our Saviour.
Amen.
Remembering the warning of the prophet Jeremiah in our first reading, we pray for every nation of the world, that we may take the way that leads to what is good for all peoples. We think especially of the work of the United Nations Organization and the work of the Commonwealth. Lord, give to the nations wisdom to understand the things that belong to their peace and the will to reject the things that make for war. And we pray that, realizing our common humanity, we may learn to live together as one family and make the world a home, bearing each other's burdens, ministering to each other's needs, as children of one God and Father, in Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
With the Anglican Communion today, we pray for the Diocese of Harare and Lake Malawi. And in this Diocese of Gloucester, we pray for David and John, our bishops, for the parishes of St. Oswald and Christ Church, Abbeydale, for their parish clergy, Ian Calder and Marilyn Charmond, and for the people they serve. We pray for the life and witness of this cathedral church, for Nick Berry as he prepares to come here as our dean. We offer to God, as always, the prayers of our visitors today, prayers of thanksgiving, prayers for healing, prayers in mourning, for them and for one another, we pray. When our lives are empty, our hearts unsatisfied, our spirits waiting, Christ of the Bethlehem stable, be born to us. When we find temptation and the seduction of power and wealth and ease and pleasure hard to face, Christ of the desert wilderness, pray with us. When we rejoice in health and happiness and well-being and feel the warmth of God's love on our faces, Christ, the water of life, walk with us. When our decisions are hard, our paths stony, and we cannot see our way, Christ of the Garden of Gethsemane, weep with us. When we face the bitter paths of suffering and loss, and when our hearts cry out for reasons why, Christ of the Cross of Calvary, stay with us. When at last we end our journey and bring our poor lives into your keeping, Christ of the empty tomb, welcome us. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
hymn this evening in English hymnal number 274.
Bless you. God the Son, heal you. God the Holy Spirit, give you strength. God the Holy and Undivided Trinity, guard your body, save your soul, and bring you safely to his heavenly country, where he lives and reigns forever and ever.